Get ready to dig deeper into their wallets. It's because the Board of Education approved a 7% increase in the cost of health benefits. Action 7 News anchor Natalie Swaby joins us live with just how much it's going to cost. Natalie?
Well, Doug, it's what APS employees are probably going to be talking about tomorrow. School district says soaring prices are to blame. Tonight I spoke with one employee who says she doesn't know how she's going to handle the increase.
I really am. Because we give our best to our students. We work hard. And we give our best.
Ms. Merle Tillman, an educational assistant with APS, and she's among the many employees who will have their medical and dental insurance each increase by 7% starting December 1st. We spoke with the president of the Educational Assistants Union. She says employees just received pay raises, but the increase approved tonight is going to cut right into that.
We keep going backwards, not forwards, backwards. And yet the work they're asking us to do has multiplied tenfold. I mean, you know, I would be embarrassed. I, as an administration of this district, I would be embarrassed.
I think it was a good compromise. Obviously, it's not going to make everybody happy. And obviously, it's something that the board and the administration wish we didn't have to do. We wish that we could have had higher salary increases for all of our employees. We wish the legislature would have allocated more dollars.
And Superintendent Winston Brooks also said that initially the proposal called for a 13% increase to the cost of their health benefits, but the board and the administration were able to get that number down to 7% by tapping into some reserve funds. Reporting live at APS headquarters, Natalie Swaby, KOAT, Action 7 News.
And copays for employees will also go up $5 for doctor visits and $25 for visits to the emergency room. And the cost of inpatient hospital care doubles to $500.